In this topic, we'll be talking about NSGs and how you create NSGs and what NSGs are, network security groups, or how you would manage traffic both into and out of either a subnet or to a NIC on a VM. And it's important to note that those are the two options. You can attach an NSG to either a subnet or a NIC on a VM, or you could do an NSG on a subnet and then subsequently do attach an NSG to a NIC on a VM in that subnet, but you can't attach an NSG to an overall virtual network, which is a little bit of a caveat there. But basically how the NSGs work is you have different rules. You have both inbound and outbound rules, and these rules are based on a number, increasing in number. So based on so the first, the lowest number you'll hit is the first rule that it will hit, and if it doesn't match whatever your rule is, it doesn't match that rule, it will go to the next rule in the sequence. And so these rules can be ports. You can open up ports inbound and outbound and control traffic that way. And also with these NSG rules, you can port those over using scripts to port those over, so you can have a bunch of different rules, and then you can attach those rules to the different NSGs using those scripts. So Kale, if you want to dive a little bit deeper into how NSGs are applied to the different environments.
Yeah, definitely. So the thing is, as Ed mentioned, when we have a VNet, let me get my pen working here. So when we have a VNet, we can basically have a virtual machine inside of there, which has a NIC attached to it in ARM. And so basically we can apply at this point, or we can apply at, and this would be the subnet that this thing sits in, we can also apply it at this point. So we basically can build a list of rules over here, and those are kind of disconnected. So we have our list of rules, and as Ed mentioned, these go from like, let's just arbitrarily say 100 to something like 300. And it would just walk down through this list until it hits one that can be applied. So this would be associated with this NSG, or it would be associated with this one, whichever way that we want to do that. We kind of have to figure out which model we want to do, though. Do we want to do it at a subnet level, or do we want to do it at an individual NIC level? And so in that case, it's kind of nice because we have our rules kind of disconnected, so we can figure out, and it's kind of flexible about which way we could kind of attach that and have those things kind of apply to restrict, you know, these kind of flows. One thing is this only does TCP and UDP. So things like ICMP, this does not filter right now. So that's a thing to keep in mind. Basically, we can do these kind of TCP and UDP filtering, but we can't do it through ICMP. And if I'll show you this stuff a little bit in action, whenever you start up a virtual machine, again, if you're using one of our templates, there's a couple different ways to get to it. But if we come in through, let's say, our virtual network and come into one of our network interfaces, you'll see that on our screen here, we basically have this network security group that gets provisioned for us. Now, we can customize that in ARM, so part of our template that we want to deploy out there, a network security group is a first-class citizen in Azure. So basically, we can customize that to our heart's content about how we want that NSG, where do we want it to be applied. We can kind of, again, modularize that in a separate template if we wanted to, and then attach that to our other ARM templates so that we're sharing the same kind of deployment mechanism when we're doing this. But when you go into the network security group, you'll see that basically here's where we configure our security rules. So again, this one's associated with the NIC. We could associate it at the subnet level, but this one happens to be at the NIC level. This is the default one. And then over here is where we get into seeing where these things actually apply. So over here, you'll see the inbound and outbound security rules. It's under the general properties. So in there, inbound is typically where we're seeing a lot of this because we want to filter things that are coming into this virtual machine. And so you can see by default, when we deploy one, nothing's exposed except for port 3389. So then we could go ahead and add other security rules here. And again, we can give them different priorities. So we could put it above the one that's there or below it. You kind of have to, just like a firewall, if anybody's configured firewalls in the past, very similar model to where the ACL is applied. Which kind of brings in another thing. We used to have a model called ACLs. And just think of those as kind of like the classic mode. Those were what we did before we had NSGs. NSGs have a lot more features, and so they don't kind of coexist. If you have something that has an ACL, it's using the older type deployment mechanism, and you probably need to port it over to ARM and use an NSG going forward. But over here, you can actually see where we would specify, you know, basically the source and the destination. We can specify port ranges. We can specify what protocol, again, TCP or UDP or either. And that's interesting, but we can also do these things like default security rules. So we can specify things that will always apply. So we can basically build these rule sets on these NSGs so that these things will always apply, and then you basically extend it and add more onto it. So it makes a really nice model for like security admins who are saying, I always want to make sure these rules get applied. We put those in default, and then maybe we put further restrictions or open things through the NSG if we needed to on a per case basis. And again, these all come through the audit log. So anybody that's using these NSGs, we don't get packet level, to be clear. So when we apply an NSG, it's going to do the filtering for us. It's not going to show us packet level details in the logs for what's happening there. It will show, and we can trigger it such that we can see when NSGs are being applied, but we can't see the packet level information. So when you look at the audit logs, that's where all the logs that will go from there. You can actually see some of that through the diagnostics logs and be able to kind of troubleshoot when you're doing this. You start applying these things. The interesting thing is just make sure that when you're deploying these things that you test each one of these out in succession, because when you're first doing this, it could be easy for you to lock yourself out of a VM and not understand what happened. Always you can come back through the portal and customize them, though. Remove the NSG if things got really bad and then start working backwards to figure out where the mistake was made. And that concludes the section on network security groups in Azure.